Hi everybody, Martin again. Today I'm tying another tarpon fly. Just a simple tarpon muddler. So the hook I'm using is a 1-0 Tiemco 600 SP. And I'm using 6-0 uni thread. You can use whatever you like. You could go heavier, but I like this. I prefer the 6-0 for the deer here, because it's quite a small bunch and I'm trimming it fairly close. So I like the 6-0 sort of buries in quite nicely. So for the tail and the collar, I'm using Spirit River Mottlebu, which is just like this. It's sort of marabou stitched up now. It looks like a lot of tail when you buy it. And it's as if it's been tie dyed or something. Really nice kind of shrimpy mottled appearance. So I'm just going to get a bunch of that tied in, sort of level with the barb. It's a bit thin. So the sort of shorter fibres come out there, so I'll just take another wee clump. The only drawback of this material is that you don't have the same length as if you're just using straight marabou. You could just use tan and just use a whole plume, an extra select. And that would, if you wanted a bigger fly, but you wouldn't have this sort of colour gradation. And then just to stop it fouling, just got to post it. Just like a parachute. Take several turns up the base of the tail, so it stands at a kind of upward angle. It's fixed there, and it's not going to wrap in the tail, wrap around the hook. Sorry, when you cast, just tidy that up a bit. At this stage, I like to come in with a wee bit of head cement, just to add some durability to the fly. So that will sort of soak into the butts of the marabou and the thread wraps here. Chew too much, just touch up your fingers, it'll squeeze it in and you'll take away any sort of excess. So to sort of smooth out the transition before the deer here, I'm going to put on a collar of the same material, just a wee bunch of mottlebu, similar thickness, and just try to tie this in the rounds. So just grip it and then just gradually sort of ease it around the shank before you take a loose thread wrap, and then pull that tight, and that should pretty much give you 360 coverage of the shank. Just tidy up, trim away all the any waste. That just makes a wee sort of creates a bit more flow in the pattern. Gives it a slight, a nicer taper, rather than just an abrupt edge and then the deer hair collar. Again, a wee bit of super glue in the butts. Excess. Then for the deer hair collar, I'm going to tie a pretty heavy collar. I'm just going to do it. The collar and the head's going to be a single bunch. So a good 2.5 pencils worth pencil widths of deer hair. You don't want to skimp on this. Take what you need, then add a bit more. When I first started tying these, I was always sort of looking at it going, you know, it looks a bit sparse, a bit too sparse, and then having to add, you know, take it back and add some more. So just make sure you get a nice big bunch of deer hair, plenty, and get it in your stacker. Give it a good stacking. It doesn't need to be dead perfect, but getting there. So I'll just take my thread till it's in line with the point with the hook, and then I'll offer up my bunch of deer hair. And I like the deer hair just to extend to the just inside the bend. So, I mean, it's up to, if you want it longer, that's fine, but it's up to you, really. But I like the sort of main edge of the bunch to be sort of just within the bend. And then two loose wraps, and then let it run round the shank. And then wind through the box, tighten it up, push it back. Right, pack it in. Get a nice good pack. Just check, make sure you've got good coverage. My deer hair's still spinning. That's a bit better. Take her up in front, you have to help stick it then. Then wrap through the butt. Oh, is that still sliding? It's still spinning on me. I don't know why. Just take a good tight wrap just to secure it. There we go. Sometimes when you've got a big thick clump and doesn't behave itself just as nice as you know, when you're tying like a wee trout size muddler. And then I'll just give it another check just to make sure, but it looks like I've got reasonably good coverage. And the last thing then, the last piece of tying is just the eyes. So, also I'll just sweep the thread back, and I'll grab one of my nylon or plastic dumbbells. Only takes a couple of turns to hold these, you know, they're not really under any pressure. Just make sure they're even. get a colour figure eights, make sure it's all tied in. And I like to just whip finish behind the eyes. And you can whip finish in front if you want, but I like the eyes just to be sort of the front. And I'll put another one on. Snip that away. And the last thing is just to trim this deer hair. Just like to sort of work my way around. Try not to cut the tips of the deer hair, leave them as your collar. And you can sort of shape it how you like, you know, you might prefer a rounder or a sort of more tapered head. It's sort of up to you. Obviously, the bigger the head, the more buoyancy is in it, the more water it pushes. I mean, this one bunch is, the hair's not going to be enough to float this hook, but it will certainly affect your sink rate. That's something to consider when you're trimming. You know, if you want to make a long presentation in front of the fly, in front of the fish, give them a long lead, then maybe a slightly bulkier head, a bit more deer hair is going to help your fly to hang there longer. You know, the slow sink rate will let you, the slower the sink rate, the longer the lead you can give a fish. Not just tarpon, any sort of fly that you're sight fishing up, any fish that you're sight fishing up in the water column. You know, some, that's why like toads and stuff, they've got they're designed to have that slow sink rate. So, that's the fly done. The last thing I'm going to do is just a wee bit of super glue on the thread wraps, just to secure everything in place, and then almost instantly, you don't really need to wait, I'll just stick some Sally Hansen's over the top of it, and that gives you a rock hard finish. The super glue and the head cement. Yeah. And there you go, there you have it. A wee simple tarpon muddler. I hope you liked that. If you did or if you didn't, leave a comment below. Also let me know what kind of flies you would like to be tying. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. Goodbye.